In this tutorial, I'll introduce you to the best diamond shader that we can use in Blender. Here's an example shader for diamond that we used to use for old versions of Blender a couple of years ago. Basically, it's a mixture of RGB glass nodes with light path and math nodes. The top two diamonds and the bottom two seem to have the same materials, but the top ones are using a much simple shader. There are two ways to create diamonds in Blender. One is by using extra objects diamonds. If you don't see diamonds, please activate an add-on called extra objects. But these diamonds don't have built-in shaders. We have to manually build a shader each time we add a new diamond. Another diamond creation method is by using an add-on called Jewelcraft. I'll share the add-on's download GitHub page link in the description below. By using this add-on, we can create diamonds and other jewels that have built-in shaders. This is it. It's only using the built-in BSDF node made for the new versions of Blender. I'll compare this node with a more complex version shortly, and we can see this one looks just the same. Here is a bit more complex diamond shader that I usually use when rendering the jewel meshes. The bottom two meshes are using this node, and the top two meshes are using the simple node. Here is the result. Again, the top one is using the simple one, and the bottom one is using a complex one. They look identical. I have created this scene by using the Jewelcraft add-on. I have moved the diamond up a bit, and rotated to align it with the ground mesh. After that, I pressed Shift D to duplicate it like this, and applied a new complex shader to the bottom two. This is what I have used for the ground mesh. As usual, sky texture was used. I went to the compositing to disable use nodes, and I have set the samples to 32 to save the render time. Anyway, please feel free to increase the render sample to higher number. The quality will get better as the number increases. This is the built-in shader for the jewels from Jewelcraft, and this is the one I would recommend. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.